Hey guys, and welcome back. So a lot of people have been talking to me about wanting to actually be in Korea or Japan, depending on where you want to be, I guess, or in Asia in general. And I think it's not as hard as some people may think. I think a lot of people have the mindset that it is hard. So because they think it's hard, they make it unimaginable, like something that they can't do, but you can totally do it. For example, I think the one thing is just having the will to want to go. When I first went to Japan, I mean, it was pretty much last minute. I was learning Japanese and I just thought like, wow, I want to go to Japan. And then there was some people that came in that went abroad to Japan and they really liked it. And they were just trying to talk to us about it to try to get more people to go to Japan on this program. And they gave you like a scholarship and so forth. And I was just like, well, I mean, I'm studying Japanese, so why not just go to Japan? I mean, I've always wanted to travel the world, so why not just do it, you know? And I just did it pretty much. I applied. I applied for some scholarships because I was in school at the time. And then I went. There's a few things, I guess, that could hold you back from that, which one could be your parents. Maybe your parents don't really want you to go, or maybe you've always been with your parents, and just leaving all that behind is hard. But if you really want to go abroad, you have to really like set goals and just know that you want to do it for yourself, and that there's going to be a lot of things that will be new to you. I mean, I experience new things every day, and there's a lot of things that I do miss about being at home, because I mean, it's home. You have like all your family and your friends and people you can really trust and count on, you know, but when you go abroad, you're all by yourself and you're starting all over, you know. I mean, moving from like this part of LA to like this part of LA, it's still like LA. So, you know, you could kind of get around, and even if not, you could just go visit your friends or family in this part of LA. Or I mean, just being in the US in general, it gets kind of more complicated the further you move apart. But it's still something that people can do every once in a while, you know, just travel back to Florida to see your family and so forth. So I think it's actually something that is attainable, but a lot of people put it like as an afterthought that it's just something very difficult to achieve, so I'm not going to do it. There are some things that come with that that make it difficult. One being that you don't really know the language. Unless you have been studying it for years and maybe you have a complete grasp on it, or maybe your parents are native of there but you were born in America or a different place like that, then maybe you already have like a grasp of the language, so you can go there and you can be okay, you know? But then there are those that didn't, like me, you know? I studied Japanese for like a year in America. I felt it was different from when I went to school abroad in Japan. The classes were not as hard as in Japan, but like in America, when I went to UCR, there was just so many classes I was taking, and like I didn't have enough time to actually focus on just like that one class, like just learning Japanese, you know. I was doing like the bare minimum of like studying Japanese while I was in school, because like I had to study all this other stuff, and everything was jam-packed with like memorizing this, you know. And I'm just like I couldn't really study Japanese the way I wanted to, you know. So like it was pretty much a culture shock when I went to Japan, and like I was like, okay, well, I studied a little bit, you know, like maybe I'll get by, you know. And people were talking, I was just like, what? You know, I was like, he said like three words I know, and I was just I was kind of excited a little bit. I was like, at least I knew those words. But like I was just like, what, you know? And then going shopping, and I'm just like, what did she ask me for? Like, it's either a few things she could have said. She could have said like, do you want a receipt? Do you want a bag? Like, you know, and just going through the list, and I'm just like, you know? And that could be like a shock to most people, you know? But if you have the will to want to go and actually move abroad, then you'll just do it, you know? You'll go through all those hardships that you're going to occur being here. I mean, I incur hardships all the time. I want to say it's not generally culture-based all the time, but it's a lack of something that you've had back home that's not here, you know, if it has to do with like food, you know, or the way they cook food, be it friends, because like when something happens, you have somebody to fall upon and you can just like talk to them about these things, you know, or your family and stuff. But like when you're abroad, like you can't just like meet up and just talk about everything, you know? You have to like maybe Skype them or Facebook them or something, you know? But like even that, it's like, oh, it's like 4 a.m. here, you know? And you're just like, oh, it's like 2 p.m. here or something, you know? And it's totally different because you just can't do everything that you were used to. But at the same time, it gives you a better outtake on life and a lot of different things. Like back home, I wouldn't have even thought, like, I mean, actually started liking America more being abroad. I mean, okay, that goes without saying, like, not going into politics and stuff like that, but just knowing what I did have back at home, you know, with the family and friends, and just being able to hang out whenever I want to, because when you move abroad, a lot of people are different from what you're used to, and a lot of cultures do have some specific things that are just culture-based, you know, the biggest one in Japan and Korea, and maybe a lot of Asia, which other people have said, is that they generally just consider friends people that they've met when they were in like high school, middle school, and elementary school for a long period of time. But a lot of people that they meet during life after that, they don't really consider them friends too much. So it is harder to make friends, especially if you are someone coming from a different country. But it's still possible. You just have to find the right people. But you know, something like that, that can be very daunting because, you know, you just want to go out there and you do want to have the best experience possible when you do move abroad. But it can be difficult, but you just have to have the will to want to do it and not let anything stop you. You just have to want to go. The second thing will probably be money. I came during school, so I had a scholarship to go. There was actually a program that was offering me more to come to Korea at the time. So the first time I should have came to Korea, pretty much, because they were offering me a full ride to come to Korea for a year. Plus, like, what is it? Some money on the side, because it was just so much money that they were going to give me to come to Korea. They really wanted me to come to Korea. And I was just like, I would totally do it, but I'm studying Japanese. Like, it kind of defeats the purpose to study Japanese. But then to be going to Korea, like, why am I in Korea again? Like, I didn't know anything, you know? It would be like, too much, I thought. Like, I was like, I don't even know how to read, like, the characters yet. At least they were gonna give me, like, a full ride to come here, and I probably should have taken that. That would have been less loans. But, I mean, you never know what would have happened if I just came here instead of going to Japan. But I still chose to go to Japan. I did get scholarships to go there, and I did apply for other scholarships, because there are a lot online to apply for those that want to study abroad. You just have to look them up, and they do have due dates, so you just have to keep track of when something is due, like an essay or the application forms and so forth. But that's also a possibility if you're in school. You could try it out for like a quarter, semester, or a year. I think the longest is a year for just studying abroad, and then if you actually like it, you could just transfer to the school. Tons of people done that. I probably would have done that, but there was no point to doing that because I was about to graduate anyway from my home university. And it could be kind of beneficial depending on where you want to be in life. Because, I mean, you have to set these goals, what you want to do in life, especially if you're going to come to Korea or whatever and you really like it. Are you going to stay in Korea for a long time? You have to set these goals, because then you have to know if you want like a Korean bachelor's degree or if you want like an American bachelor's degree. And you also have to be wary of them not working in certain countries. America, sad to say, but like all of them, I don't think there is any school that is not recognized in the world because it's America. But all of those can be used in like different parts of the world. But Japanese degrees and Korean degrees, it depends on what school you go to at sometimes, and if the people kind of know that school. Seoul University, maybe Yonsei, any of the popular ones like here, or, you know, Tokyo University. Universities that are well known, those will like get you by if you want to use those back in America. If you plan to probably be in Korea for maybe a few years, or Japan for a few years, but then you want to return home after that, then you do have that option of already having your home degree. But if you get yours at like a school that pretty much nobody knows of, they have to try to verify it and stuff, and some people don't want to, or they don't think, or they're kind of iffy about it, like, did you actually study? It's not the American school system, so maybe it's not as good and stuff like that, and that can be a problem. So it's also like setting those goals and knowing where you want to end up in life. For money, if you also just want to come just to teach, that's also your other option. But the only way to teach is to already have your bachelor's degree. But if you teach in Korea, they pay for your plane ticket to Korea and back, depending on what franchise or what company you go through. They pay for certain things like that. Besides that, you know, Japan was a little bit different. Japan, you have to save up enough money, and like companies will tell you how much money you need to hold out for like the time until you get your first paycheck. When I worked for Interact, I think they wanted you to save about $5,000. That's like paying for the plane ticket and paying for the first 3 months of your apartment, because in Japan, they usually make you pay for the first like 3 months of your apartment. So that's what I ended up doing. That was about like, I don't know, $1,000+. So pretty much you had like $2,000+ to last you a month and a half till you got your first paycheck. And honestly, that was a lot of money. You know, it just depends. Like if you're gonna go crazy and like, you know, I need to go visit this, and then yeah, you probably might not have that much money, you know. But if you're not going to do that, I mean, I think I only spent like $200-$300 in that month. Granted, I cook a lot, so it was easy for me to kind of save money. So if you're a miniature chef or something in the kitchen, then you are good. If you are not a chef and you eat out a lot, then, you know, you'll spend more money. You probably would have spent like, I don't know, maybe $400 to $500, give or take how much you spend in a day to survive. But still, you would have still had over like $2,000 left. So they kind of give you like an estimate of how much they think you should take. But I think that's for security reasons, because you do pay for train fees and stuff like that. So it's just so you're safe. They just don't want anything to happen to you, so they give you a general figure. But they don't check it. Like, they don't say like, do you have $5,000? Can I see it? You know, they just say like, do you kind of have in a general area? Did they even ask me? I don't even think they did. I don't think they asked me at all. But obviously, just, you know, be safe. You don't want to go to a different country and not have any money. Like, that's not a thing to do. But I've ran into people that have done that. Like, I only have this much money to last me till next month or something. I'm just like, oh no. Like, being at home, that's okay. You could probably fall back on family or something. But being abroad, you don't have anybody to fall back on. Unless you went abroad with friends or family or something like that, that will take care of you. But like I said, for money-wise and stuff, it's just setting those goals. But if you're in school already, then that's, I think school is the best time to travel abroad and just experience those different cultures that you've always wanted to experience. Because you just never know if you'll like it. A lot of people, which is probably like the third thing, is like knowing why you want to come abroad. In the first place, because some people come abroad because they like K-pop or something, you know? Yeah, I like K-pop. Okay, one thing about that, if you're gonna come abroad to see K-pop or K-pop concert, it's probably not the best thing. The only reason why is because it's like crazy to get into them, as I've heard here, so there'd be no point to like coming abroad just to go to like a K-pop concert, because the likelihood of you getting in is probably zero to none. So I probably would stop that one. I'm just saying. But if you just like the culture to begin with or something like that, or always want to learn the language, then very beneficial to come abroad. Because when I was in college, I didn't have the actual time to study Japanese, but then moving abroad, like I had to kind of focus more on Japanese if I wanted to survive there. There are some people that go abroad and they don't know any, you know, they probably pick up some like learning capabilities of like, oh, you're saying this, like, okay, I got you. But then they respond in English and then the person's probably like, what? You know, or they try like that. But that becomes difficult to me after some time. Like, I just want to be able to just like fluently, like just talk to you, like, let's just go. But if you're trying to talk to me in like Japanese and I'm trying to respond to you in the basic English that I think that you may know, like, it works depending on where you are. Like if you're more in Tokyo area, but like if you're like in like the countryside, then it doesn't work as well. So it's taking all of that into account. Do you really want to learn a language? A ton of people that probably just, I don't know, I'll put it like this. They just always wanted to date somebody from like Korea or Japan, or, you know, they really like Koreans or Japanese people or something like that. So that's the reason why they go. But, you know, those type of people, when they find their significant other, they know Japanese or they know Korean and English. So that helps them to actually get, I don't know, to build a life here, because your significant other, you're living in Japan, your significant other knows Japanese and English, so they pretty much say everything for you, you know, you're good. Or in Korea, your significant other speaks Korean and English, so they do all that for you, you know. But if it's your goal to actually learn the language, then just do that. You know, I'm doing that now, but it's really my goal. Like, I'm going to school, and that's what I'm doing. I'm going to school. So that's what I'm doing now. But it's just having those goals and knowing what you want out of the culture that you're going to go to. If you really like something, then yeah, try it out and see if you like it, you know. That's like the best thing you could do. Granted, to go abroad, you do need a degree if you're trying to teach or something like that, or if you want to work abroad. You don't have to teach, but if you want to work abroad and, you know, do any of those other things, you do need a degree to do that. They don't specify what degree you actually need, but for some certain companies, they may ask you to have this degree or that degree. But also, it could be knowing the actual language, because you're in Korea now, so do you know Korean? You know, and like I said, some people can get by without knowing it, but it boosts your chances of getting a good job and so forth if you actually know the language. If you don't, then like, you can only choose from like this amount of jobs, because you don't really know Korean or you don't really know Japanese. So that's actually beneficial to actually study the language before you come and study it while you're here, you know. But I think the end game is that, like, I did it because I've always wanted to travel. I've always wanted to go abroad and just travel the world and go to different countries. You know, I started at Japan because I was listening to Japanese music and I was like, wow, what are they saying? I don't know. So let's learn Japanese, you know, and that's how I started learning Japanese. I learned so much more about myself, because there's a lot of things that you don't think about being back at home, because you don't have to think about it really. And I constantly think about a lot of different things, but I didn't have to, because I was already surrounded by things that I was used to, you know, like being able to hang out with friends a lot and talk to friends a lot and all that stuff, because everybody did that. Or at least my circle did. I don't know. Is it different in other parts of America? Maybe I'm just like totally wrong, you know, but everyone did that. And then I came abroad and nobody did that. I'm just like, wow, like, like, y'all don't talk to each other? Like every so often, like, what? Wow. And then if you talk too much, it's like, oh, you must be dating. No, I just want to hang out, you know, have fun. Can we go to a movie or something? Oh, you know, but a lot of that stuff, you don't really think about it, because for me, it was always there. But coming abroad, like, I realized, like, wow, like, I was able to do so many things, like, a lot easier back home, just because that's what I'm used to. And that right there is like a kind of culture thing, because, like, maybe if I grew up, if I grew up here, then I'd already have friends, so I wouldn't have thought about it. So yeah, like, maybe it's not a cultural thing, it's just a difference of meeting people and so forth. But honestly, just like from this video, I just want you to get that, like, it's attainable to come abroad. Some people think that it's not, and I think you put it at the back of your head and you just assume that you're never gonna make it. And you do, you live through the videos that you see people create, and that's cool. I mean, like, if I knew I was coming abroad too, you know, then maybe I would do that too. I would try to learn more about it, you know. But me, it was kind of different, because, like, I just started learning Japanese. They came into class and I was like, I'll just go. So honestly, mine was like, what, like a split second decision. Like, they came in and said, and I was like, let's go, like, let's go to Japan. I didn't have to think about it for a long time. I really didn't. They came in, and then, like, that same night, I told my mom, like, I'm going to Japan. Granted, some stuff happened, because there was an earthquake in Japan that same day, but actually, I hate saying that, but that's just how it happened for me. You know, I just knew I wanted to go, and I just did it. I just said, I'm gonna go, and I went. Granted, I was poor, like, I had no money to my name. The one thing, if you're new to my channel, that you probably don't know is I paid for my whole university by myself. I paid for living abroad by myself. I always worked and went to school, so I paid for everything myself. I even paid off my loan already, but by myself. I never had help. So what I'm saying is, like, anything is possible if you actually try, but you have to have the willpower to want to do it. And if I didn't have the willpower, I would not have paid off my loan. I would not have, you know, come to Japan, come to Korea. You know, it would have just all been stuck in my head. You just have to want to go and do it. But that is it. If there's anything else you want to know, I'm sure there are going to be more videos where I'll talk about a lot of different things like that. But yes, until then, I will see you guys later. Bye. You're still here? Thanks for watching the video until the end. Please don't forget to check out the description box below for info on my friends that were in the video.
Hi!
Product links, my other social media platforms, and my new product designer. If you guys love the video, please don't forget to like and subscribe. And don't forget to comment, because I really love reading and writing back to comments that fans leave. And thanks for watching. See you guys next time. Bye.